Hello everyone, it's Axolta here, and welcome back to my channel. Today we are playing Agatha Knife once again, because I fucking love this game and I haven't played in a while, because I recorded that videos like in fucking June. So yeah, I haven't played this game in a while. Yeah, also I see my probably here, I'm a bit sick, that's why I haven't uploading that much lately, because I've been, you know, trying just to survive while being sick, because I felt horrible. But yeah, now I don't feel that bad, you can still hear it, probably, because my nose is quite stuffed right now. But yeah, that will not stop us. Oh, we had to look into the confessional. The man from the religion creating courses said there's someone in there. Let's go! Also, oh, hello. Anyone there? Shh, don't shout. What do you want? I put my name down for the course on creating religions. The man over there told me to talk to you. Have you got my registration form? Yes. Very good. Leave it in a tray. Okay, so let's pat her on the head. Pat. Nice. I put the form in the tray. Okay, let's see. So, Agatha, a young butcher with insomnia. You want to create a religion that will help bring customers back to your store and make your animals happy while you could cut them up with your knife and then bleed to death, is that correct? Pretty much. An interesting case and a challenge, that's for sure. I like it. Let me have a think about it. And I'll put together a list of the things we'll need to do to create a religion which fits your needs. I'm not sure how long the planning process will take, so there's no need for you to wait around. You can go home. As soon as I've got everything ready, I'll contact you. One thing, it's very important. For the moment, don't tell anyone about what we are planning here. If someone gets wind of all this, they won't believe in your religion and then the plan won't be of any use. Oh my god. Don't say anything to anyone until I'll tell you. Okay, but is that it? I don't need to do anything else? Not at the moment. We'll talk when I thought through all the steps we need to take. Okay, until then, bye. Hope this works out. Anyway, let's go home. Oh, I got an achievement, darn, I know. Yeah, I don't know why, but it's much harder for me to speak in English right now when I'm sick. When I have stuffed nose. I don't know why, I kinda seen that, felt that today at school. Like, I have some maths, and like I was speaking alright with my friends and all stuff, all of that. But then when English lesson come and I had to read some text, I just couldn't fucking speak, like, what the hell, it was so much harder. Wild. I don't know why, maybe I speak more using my nose, hi, I don't know, let's speak to the mother. Let's go back to the British appointment. I want to go home. Yes, me too, I'm tired of praying. Anyways, let's go. So, and I feel it right now, like I was talking with my boyfriend like a few minutes ago. Oh my god, my light, my ring light is... Wait, okay. Looks like another day without any customers. I hope going to church was useful and things pick up. Don't worry about mom, I'm sure things will get better soon. Him, whatever you say, Agatha. By the way, I'm pretty sure it's time to prepare our last pick. Can you deal with it? We probably won't sell any of the meat. But at least we'll have something else on the counter should anyone come in. Okay, I'll deal with it. Thanks! The meat is going bad because nobody has come in to buy it. A disaster. Meat with flies all over it. Gross. Okay, when I... Why doesn't anyone come to the store anymore? No idea, Agatha. You know better than anyone that our meat has always been of premium quality and I can't put the prices down any further. If we don't get customers through the door soon, we won't be able to pay the bills or buy more animals to have meat to sell. In fact, we only got one pig left, although if the customers don't come, we have to close the shop. And we won't need any more animals. I hope we find a solution. We'll get the customers back, mom. Trust me. Soon we have lots of animals in abattoir? I don't know how to read this. Sorry. And the customers will be packed full of good fresh meat just like before. Thank you, Agatha. You're my favorite daughter. Oh, do I have any siblings? No. Ah. Let's do something else. I'll see you later, mom. Okay, I'll be right there. Hi, mom. The meat waving scales. Spum. Cans of processed meat. Even the cheapest things don't sell. Can of processed meat. Okay, let's go. There's a pig waiting for me in the back room. When I have crate filled up, we can leave. Oh, right, this way. Huh? I'm thinking. Okay, I have to like, count my time. Oh my god, I got so scared. This isn't the back room. What's going on? Yeah, what's going on? Cloves of garlic species and different colored Caucasians. Maybe this guy is a cook. I don't think so. Ah, okay. Various jars, a radio and string of garlic. Okay. A crystal ball. A poster of the awesome Sandro. A bookcase with books and glass jars in it. I'm sure he'll know how I got here. Hello, hello Agatha, welcome. Have you met before? How do you know my name? I know because I am... Sandro, the awesome master of divination. To my friends, awesome Sandro. Nice, this guy has like poster with himself. Amazing. Never heard of you. I'm your mentor. I'm going to help you create your own religion. Ah, so that was you in the little wooden house. Yes. Wow, that was quick. I thought it would take longer for us to meet. Anyway, how did I get here where we are? This is my control center where I give in-depth personalized advice. This is where I receive and oriented all of my students. Given that you don't have a telephone number or an email, they told me to get in touch with you using special means. So I teleported you here. You teleported me here? And how did you do that? Are you a magician too? I already told you, I'm Sandro, also master of divination. Yeah, I got it, but what does that mean? Are you a magician or not? Pretty much. In addition to being an expert in teleportation, I can tell you the future. My specialties are tarotation, burpination, salamingshotination, and all of the other divinations that you can ever think of. I'm a master of all divination because I am. As from Sandro, yeah, I got it. But what are these divinations? They're metaphysical techniques or magical arts that are used to see the future. Ugh. And what has that got to do with religion? A great deal, because just like religion, magic is based on faith. In the end, all that matters is that the people believe in it. But don't you worry, you just need to trust me. Let's get to work on carnivorism. That's why you're here, after all. Carnivorism. Yes, carnivorism. That will be the name of your religion. Given that you like to eat meat, you're a butcher, and that your problems are related to those things, I thought that carnivorism would be the ideal name for your religion. What do you think? Sounds good. And what does carnivorism involve? Well, all religions are based on a perfect lie which is able to transform fear into faith. You will develop each of the necessary components to create the perfect lie. Me? But you're going to help me, aren't you? Yes, of course, I'll give you guidance whenever you need it. That's why I have my fabulous deck of cards. What do you need deck of cards for? I know I ask a lot of questions, but it's because there are lots of things about religion and faith that I don't understand yet. Don't worry. Well, as we progress through the course, you will become an expert. Returning to the subject at hand, when you don't know what to do to obtain the component you're searching for, let me know and I'll see what the cards say. The cards will show us something that will help us move forward. For example, the first thing Calvinism needs is a god. And before you ask, a god is a superior, imaginary and powerful being. A god is one in charge of a religion, so we need one. Once we have a god, the followers of carnivorism will do what he says. Although in reality, it will be what you say, but we can worry about that later. Okay? And where can I find God? It's for precisely that reason that we have the cards that show us the way. Let's see what they say. Fun fact, I'm working with tarot cards for like some time. I think a year or two, or I don't know, something like that. I don't know, and I'm not very good at it, but like sometimes it works. Oh my god, what they say? Tell me. Okay, we got the dagger, the blood, and the drunk. And what does that mean? It means that it will be necessary to find the blood of an animal. I don't think that will be difficult. Excellent. Take this bottle. Fill it with animal blood and bring it back to me. With the blood, we will be able to create the god of carnivorism. Won't we need anything else? With just the blood, we'll be able to create a god. You just worry about bringing me the bottle full of blood, you will see. Okay, but can you send me back to the butchers? Sure, if you live through the door, you will go directly. I'll take care of bringing you back once you've got the animal blood. Okay, see you soon then, I guess. See you soon. Let's leave. Piggy! No! I'm back at Butters. Amazing. Okay. Oh my god. This game's so bad. Like, I think many people will not be able to watch this game. Like, my sister is vegetarian just because she hates the think about killing the animals. Anyway, my work tools. Gimme. I'm not, don't worry. Very good, my machine. I don't need this sharpener. Okay. Yeah, and also, like, yeah. I have forgotten what I wanted to say. But yeah. Piggy bank. That's where I put my money. My mom gives me for working here. I've told her that she doesn't pay, need to pay, but it makes her feel happier, so I just take it. The money could come in handy, but we need to smash the piggy bank first. No, not the piggy bank. Sorry, friend piggy. Our last pig. I've enjoyed his company, but his time has come. I hope we get some new animals soon, or he'll be really lonely. Girl, I don't think he can be lonely, like, sorry, Mr. Piggy. Okay, sorry. Amazing. Now, let's get to the work. I hope it's not too graphic. Please? Okay, it's not. Oh! It is! Maybe, I don't know. Is this too much for YouTube? Or it's not? Okay, I don't make money on this, so like, fuck it. Job done. Piggy! My dear friend Piggy, I'm so sorry. Let's take some blood. Let's leave. Hello, Sandro. I like being transported. It takes a bit, but it's relaxing. I have problem with saying R today. Maybe, like, with this nose. I don't know. But only in English. Maybe because, like, in Polish you have, like, yes. Oh my god. The R in Polish is like so different to pronounce, like your whole mouth just goes differently. Yeah, maybe that's sorry. At some point I would say R, like R. It's like vibrating my tongue. It's glowing, guys. What have you done to the blood, and why have you given back to me? To find the god of carnivorism, we need a special potion made of animal blood. At least that's what the card said. We added some of my magic spices to the blood and create an awesome elixir with my magic cocktail mixing skills. Oh. Now you have to drink it from the bottle. Don't drink it all through. Take a swing and the potion starts to take effect. I'll explain the rest. Okay? It's like drugs. This concoction actually tastes pretty good. I know. Every year I do a tour of thousands of hotels so that everyone can try my magnificent cocktails. And Sandra, I'm not interested in your stories. Why are you so mean? Why are you so rude? Yes, but what do I do now? How long does it take for the potion to take effects? Not long, wait a little while. A little bit more. Almost there. Okay, let's begin. What? Agatha? Hello, Sandro. Where are you? I can see you. Right now, I'm inside your head. You can wave very much. I can't feel anything. I'm in your mind, Agatha. I'm using my special powers to connect your dominant imaginarium with your reality. In other words, you're navigating through your own imagination. And if all goes well, the god of carnivorism will appear. At least that's what the card said. Okay. God, I can tell you that you're starting to trust me. That's the spirit. I don't see that I have a choice. Well, I guess I can work with that. Anyway, can you tell me what you see around you? Right now it's really dark. The only thing that I can see is that I'm standing in a puddle of blood. Anything else? Is anyone there with you? I don't think so. Hang on. I can see a shadow. I think there's something approaching. Oh no, I'm scared. And it's huge. Wow, it's a giant pig. A pig? That makes sense. Hello, giant pig. Yes, it's me. And what's your name? Oh, does it hurt? Oh, that's good. So that's you? Okay, hang on a minute. Hey, Sandro, tell me. I found the god of carnivorism. Oh, really? Yes, he's a giant pig called the Great Bleeding Pig. Oh, the Great Bleeding Pig. Say it like that. Okay, he wants to tell me something else. Yes. Oh. Yes, sometimes that can happen. I like it rare too. Okay, Agatha, you've met the god of carnivorism. That's all we need. Say goodbye and I'll disconnect you. You're so right. Soldiers are very much undervalued. Agatha? Is that even possible? Inside? Are you listening to me, Agatha? Come back right now. Seriously? That's enough. I need to bring her back before it's too late. What do I need to do to get in? Get in. Wait, where are you going? Already so soon? But I need your help. It's so fucking scary to me. I don't know why. Why? But they say I wanted to go in. Please don't go. Great Bleeding Pig. Okay. Great Bleeding Pig. It's over, Agatha. I've disconnected you from your dormant imaginarium. Why did you disconnect me? I was hanging out with the Great Bleeding Pig. I got that. The Great Bleeding Pig doesn't exist. What do you mean he doesn't exist? He seemed real to me. Yeah, he isn't real. You created the Great Bleeding Pig with your imagination, based on all the dominant thoughts in your mind. And with the help of my awesome cocktail, of course, later on, for all this to work, you have to convince others that he exists. But no matter what, you must remember that the Great Bleeding Pig is nothing more than a symbol. At all, just another piece of carnivorism puzzle. Made up god for a made up religion. Okay. That's a shame, we were getting on really well. But yes, I understand. The great billing thing doesn't exist because I invented him. But I can use him as the god of carnivorism to convince. Hey, who do I need to convince? Don't worry about that at the moment. There are still some other things that we need to find. But before I forget, what were you and the great billing thing talking about? What does it matter if not all of it was real? It wasn't real, but maybe what you were talking about could be useful. Right, well, he told me that he really likes sausages and that he likes meat rare, just like me. He also mentioned that deep inside he has everything that I need to solve my problems. Interesting. And what does that mean exactly? I don't know, he just was going to explain. You disconnected me, sorry, but I risked you. I was talking to you and you didn't respond. If I hadn't disconnected you on time, you would have been forever trapped in your own imagination. Ah, in that case, thanks. No problem. Maybe I should drink some more of the potion from the bottle and that way I can speak to the great limping again. That's not a good idea, it's too soon. You should leave more time between journeys into your dormant imaginarium. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Let's get on with finding the next part of carnivorism. Yes, we got a god, now we need a sacred book. And in that book we'll put together all the necessary principles to ensure that carnivorism makes sense and will be useful. And what principles are those? First, get your hands on a book, we'll worry about the principles later. Okay. We need a thick book with loads of pages. Loads of blank pages, that is. Does that even exist, a book with blank pages? I don't know, you have to look for one. And if you can find one, you can make one yourself. Okay, I'll think of something. I'll go outside and take a look around and see what I can find. Excellent. By the way, even that we are talking about the sacred book of carnivorism, perhaps the cover should be red? I like it. Okay, that's decided. Find a book with lots of blank pages and red cover. When you have it, you will... we'll write the principles of your new religion, and with that we'll have this sacred book of carnivorism, and we'll be one step closer to saving your problems. I'll get on with it then. Good luck. Remember that if you need help, we can always consult the cards. Okay, but first I'm going to take a look around and see what I can find. As you wish, you know where to find me. Yeah, let's go. Okay, I think I'll end this video here. It's a bit longer than usual, but like, I don't know, many things happened today. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. Remember to comment if you like this video, leave a like if you like this video, like thumbs up, you know, and subscribe to my channel if you like me. Remember to check out my other series like Tacoma, and like tell me why. I know I haven't recorded the first video, like the last video yet, but I want to be ready for that. Okay, never mind. And also SANDRO 4, which may be like. Like, Magroska's computer broke some days ago, so I don't know when we'll record the next video, but like, check out the two we got for now. And yeah, that's all for today. Thank you once again, and bye!